town of Brigus, with a population approaching 1,100, is located on the Avalon Peninsula of Newfoundland, along the southwestern portion of Conception Bay, approximately 55 miles west of the provincial capital of St. John's. Surrounded by a band of rugged hills, the community is situated in a small valley from which extends a narrow and deeply curved bay. Brigus was originally settled in the 17th century, first by migratory fishermen using the Brigus Harbour as a temporary summer fishing ground, and later by small groups of fishermen and their families emigrating permanently from various parts of the British Isles. From the time of its settlement up until the middle of the 20th century, Brigus's economy was subsistence-based and centered primarily around the inshore cod fishery. During the 18th and 19th centuries, Brigus enjoyed a prosperous economy. But in the 20th century, with the decline of the inshore fishery and the general impact of the worldwide depression, many people began to search out more viable employment alternatives. Today, Brigus's economy is vastly different from what it once was. Though many people continue to carry on subsistence activities, such as fishing, hunting, and gardening, there is only a small percentage who continue to depend solely on these activities for their livelihood. Enjoy a great deal of liberty in their play activities. Open space abounds everywhere and allows the children the freedom to explore their natural surroundings, the woods to the north, south and west, and the sea to the east. The children's free play mirrors and anticipates their future adult activities involved with the woods and the sea. In the fall of the year, towards the end of September or the beginning of October, neighborhood groups of children, ranging in age from 7 to 18, can be seen engrossed in what at first appears to be work activity, but what in fact is play. Come fall, the adolescents begin their lengthy and diligent preparations for one of the most looked forward to celebrations of the year, the November 5th Bonfire Night. Early in the gathering stages, the children go from house to house and from store to store, asking the adults for anything combustible that is no longer in use. Paper, cardboard boxes, pieces of wood, old boats, and discarded furniture. Especially prized now, and the main ingredient in the fires, are rubber tires. An excursion is often made out to the woods or to Molly's Island to chop down trees and boughs for the fire as well. This activity takes a full day, for once the children have chopped down what they consider to be adequate fuel, they must also haul the wood down to the cliffs and pile it in the boat to transport it across the harbor to their place of storage. Another means by which the children gather materials is jigging for tires in the harbour just off the fish plant wharf. These tires are either thrown off the wharf at other times of the year by people who have no use for them because they're old or flat, or they are tires that have accidentally fallen off one of the fishing boats. However the tires find their way to the harbour floor, Come October, they are ready game for these mock fishermen. They decide on a centralized storage area, a place that is large and safe from the potential thievery of another group. This is often a barn, a basement, or a deserted house. As materials trickle in, they are put in storage under lock and key. On the afternoon of the day of the bonfire, each group assembles its manpower and begins to transport the materials to their destination. For each neighborhood group, there is almost always a specially designated place where the bonfire is burned each year. The place chosen is frequently on a high promontory where it can be viewed by the entire community. As the materials are brought up to the designated spot, they are arranged in a pyramid-like structure. The remaining materials are put in a reserve heap nearby for ready use when needed. This celebration, which originated in England, is a commemoration of the occasion of November 5th, 1605, when a group of Catholic conspirators, one of them named Guido Fawkes, were caught in their attempt to blow up the Protestant Parliament. The Bonfire Festival developed as an annual reenactment of the hanging of Guido Fawkes and became known in England as Guy Fawkes Night. Time has dulled original intent with shifts in geographical locality and in a different cultural context. This celebration has taken on new characteristics and motives as it is enacted in many communities, including Brigus. For most of the older members of the community, this celebration is connected in some manner to England's Guy Fawkes Night, though it holds more immediate significance as well. Time for all the garbage and useless things in the yard to be gotten away with. But for the children, who are the active participants in the celebratory activities, its significance involves an entirely different arena of thought and action from its original manifestation. It is a playtime of lengthy and diligent neighborhood group preparations for the biggest and best bonfire in the place